It really makes all of this work worth it to be able to create an additional population for something that truly is on the brink of extinction. The North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission entered into a landmark agreement with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service in November of 2022. This is the Programmatic Safe Harbor and Candidate Conservation Agreement for 21 aquatic species in North Carolina. And it focuses on achieving recovery for these species through reintroduction.
Did you see that they're already laying eggs in here?
They were so not bothered by your transportation. They lay eggs.
So what we're doing is taking out the cold water and adding the warm water, so.
We're pretty close.
Yeah. You'll look at me there.
Okay.
Andy Wood had been keeping the snails in captivity since the late 1990s. Had the only population in captivity. When we got to know Andy, we took some of his snails to a hatchery facility at NC State 2011-2012. And then we also took a portion to one of our hatcheries in Pender County to establish a third population there. After the time, we had some water quality conditions at Watho were not suitable for the snail anymore, so we moved the animals to our Marion State Fish Hatchery, where they've been living ever since then.
I think the most difficult thing that was a barrier to getting these snails back out into the wild was finding suitable habitat for them.
Most of the pH in the surface waters down there are between 4.5 and 5, which is too acidic for the snails to complete their life cycle. So we had to do a lot of searching and a lot of testing of all different kinds of ponds before we finally found the right one that met all of their needs. All of them were old mill ponds or municipal ponds where they had been found in some surveys as far back as the 1700s. Found over time, their populations had been extirpated or completely died out.
The Safe Harbor and Candidate Conservation Agreements are voluntary agreements between non-federal landowners and the state. And the act of reintroducing a species into this area where there are zero individuals is a conservation benefit. Not only are we helping with preventing extinction, but we've been able to restore the species back to its historical range preliminarily and to see how it does so it can establish and reproduce.
Well, out in the pond, we have these what we call turtle exclosures, and are really meant to protect the plants that we put in there from turtle predation. We decided to stock the snails in those to at least give them a chance to be protected from the turtles before they made their way out through that mesh. After we reintroduced the snails, we were monitoring them weekly through the end of the year. Looking under leaves for egg masses and looking for adult snails in the water and on vegetation. Checking to see different size classes. That is an indication to us that they're reproducing and continuing to grow.
This has been a long time coming, the reintroduction of magnificent ramshorn back into the wild. This is a great example of a species that has had a tremendous history and a tremendous effort of multiple partners in order to help prevent extinction.
Just looking around at all the other people who have spent, you know, years and decades of their lives working on this project, I felt really lucky to be involved in something that was so hopeful and so far has a really positive outcome.